My name is Andy Hart. I'm a scientist at Fera in the UK and also work with EFSA. I have a special interest in things that are, well, uncertain, which is what I'm here to talk to you about today. Virtually all decisions in life are affected by uncertainty. For example, when we travel by car, we have to decide when to start in order to get to our destination on time. We know there might be delays due to traffic or other problems, so we are uncertain how long the journey will take. We might get an estimate of the journey time from a travel website, but it will rarely be precisely correct. The actual time might be shorter if the journey goes well, or longer if there's more traffic. It might take much longer if our car breaks down, but that's less likely. So there is a range of possible times the journey might take, and some are more likely than others. That means that there's a risk of arriving late. To reduce the risk, we may decide to allow more time for the journey, especially if arriving late would have bad consequences. The more time we allow, the lower our risk of being late. The same principles apply to decisions on food safety. Scientists might be asked for advice on the risk from a chemical or a new food or disease. We use the best available science to give the best advice we can, but there will be limits to how much we know. For example, there will be some uncertainty about the levels of a chemical in the food, about how much is eaten, and consequently, how much of the chemical people are exposed to. Also, we won't know precisely how toxic the chemical is, which affects where we set the safe level for it. So, as for the journey time with the car, our estimate of the exposure will be uncertain. There's a range of possible values, and some are more likely than others. As a result, there may be a chance of exposure being above the safe level, as well as a chance of being below it. Once again, decisions that are made will be affected by the uncertainty. If the chance of exceeding a safe level is high enough, then those responsible for making decisions may consider removing the chemical or replacing it with an alternative. The role of scientists is to provide scientific advice. The critical point is that our advice should be more than just a best estimate. People making decisions need information on the range of things that might happen and how likely they are. If the uncertainty is just too great to provide this, then we need to make that clear so it can be taken into account in decision making. So, when you see information on uncertainty, that isn't a failure of science. On the contrary, we need information on uncertainty. We can never be certain of the future, but if we take account of uncertainty, we can make better decisions, both in food safety and in everyday life.